I welcome you all to this problem solution series in digital electronics. I am solving the problems from the book Digital Design by Maurice Mano and Michael Celletti. So in this video, I am solving the problem number 6.25 from the chapter number 6. So the problem is, it is necessary to generate 6 repeated timing signals T0 through T5 similar to the ones shown in figure 6.31C. Okay, so this figure you can find from the book. Okay, then we are asked to design a circuit using flip-flops only, and in the second case we can use a counter and a decoder. Okay, so let us see first of all this figure 6.31C. So this is the figure 6.31. Okay, this is part C. So here we can see that 2-bit counter, and here we have a count enable. Okay, so this counter will start counting whenever we have a high signal here, and this counter has 2 bits. That means from 00 it will go up to 11. That is, from 00 it will go to 01, from 01 it will go to 10, and from 10 it will go to 11. Here we have 4 states, and for the 4 states, that means for 00 this T0 will have a high signal, for 01 this T1 will have a high signal, and for 10 this T2 have a high signal, okay, and all the others will be 0, and for 11 this T3 will have the high signal. So here in the part B we can see that we have this clock signal, okay, and here we can see that for the after this first negative edge, this T0 going high up to this negative edge, okay, at the second negative edge this T1 is going high, okay, for one clock cycle, and for this after this second negative edge, what will happen, this third T2 will go high, okay, and similarly after this fourth, that is 11 output of this counter, 2-bit counter, this fourth output, that is T3, will go high for 1 clock period. Using ring counter with 6 flip-flops, we can design this circuit. That means we have to use here 6 number of flip-flops, because in a ring counter, the number of states, that means the number of states it can count, is equal to the number of flip-flops used. That means for a ring counter, the number of states is equal to this number of states is equal to the number of flip-flops used. Okay, so here we have to generate 6 repeated timing signals. So here we have to use a 6-bit ring counter. So let me draw the circuit. So here we'll have 6 flip-flops. Let us use here D flip-flops. So suppose this is 1. Suppose this is 2nd flip-flop. This is suppose 3rd flip-flop. This is 4th flip-flop. This is 5th flip-flop. And here we have a 6th flip-flop. And the details of the ring counter you can find from the other counter section, okay, page number 289. Suppose here we have, assume this is flip-flop 0. So what we'll do, the first flip-flop output, this is Q0, suppose this is Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5. These are the outputs. So here we'll have the inputs. Suppose these are the D flip-flops, so here we'll have D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5. So these are the 6 flip-flops from 0 to 5. So for designing this ring counter, the first flip-flop output will be connected to the second flip-flop input. So similarly, the second flip-flop output, that is flip-flop 1 output, is connected to this flip-flop 2, and similarly for all the other flip-flop. And what we'll do, the last flip-flop output will be connected to the first flip-flop input. So this is the ring counter. Here we'll apply synchronous clock signals. Here we have to apply one override input. Suppose here we have this preset, and this is active low input. Okay, so this preset will be connected to one override input. So here we have ORI. This is override input. That means whenever we have this signal, it will override the output states in respective of the input states of these flip-flops. This override input will be connected to the preset input of this first flip-flop, that is FF0. Okay, and it will be connected to the clear CLR. Okay, these are the active low clear input. Okay, CLR. And this override input will be connected to all the clear inputs. Okay, so that means whenever we have a zero here or we have an active low signal at this override input, this first flip-flop will be set because we have connected into the preset pin. Okay, and all the other flip-flops will be cleared. Okay, that means all the other flip-flop output will go to zero. When we have preset is equal to zero, then this Q0 will be equal to 1. Okay, that means the first flip-flop output will be 1. When we have clear equal to 0, all these outputs Q1 equal to Q2 equal to Q3 equal to Q4 equal to Q5 is equal to 0. So whenever we have a low signal, active low signal at this override input, this preset will be zero, getting zero. So that means this first flip-flop output will be 1 and this rest of this flip-flop output will be 0. Now what we'll do, we'll see the operation of this circuit. Suppose here we have this override input, then we have suppose clock input, then we have suppose Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5. So whenever we have an active low signal here at this override input, so what will happen? The irrespective of this clock signal, that means don't care on the suppose there is clock or not. Okay, so what will happen? This first flip-flop output will be 1 and the rest of the flip-flop will be 0. Okay, so at the first step we will have this first flip-flop output is 1 and these flip-flop outputs are 0 0 0 0 0. Suppose now we have made this override signal for all the remaining steps is equal to 1. Suppose we have 1 1 1 1 1. In this way we have made this override signal high, so that this override signal has no impact after this first preset and clear operation. Suppose we have made this override signal high. Okay, now we will apply the clock signal. Suppose here we have this active low triggering. We can use it in the positive edge also, in the negative edge also. Suppose we have used here a negative edge triggering. So whenever we have negative edge of the clock, this output will change. Okay, so whenever we have this first negative edge, this flip-flop will change its output depending on the input. So previously it has zero, so it is a D flip-flop, it will transfer here zero. That means after 1 it will become 0. Okay, so previously this output was 1, so it will be transferred with the, because it is a synchronous clock signal. So this 1 will come here and this 0 will come here. This 0, first 0 will come here. Okay, and here we'll have 0 and 0. After the first negative edge, that is after activating all these flip-flops using this negative edge of the clock, what will happen? This flip-flop outputs will be have a transition depending on the input. Now we have after this first clock we have 0 1 0 0 0 0. So here we'll have 0 1 0 0 0 0 0. So here we have to find out up to Q5. Okay, whenever we have this next clock negative edge, what will happen? This flip-flop again have a transition. So now here we have 0 input, so it will become 0 output. So here we have 0 input, so here we will have 0. Now at this input of this D2, we have 1 previously, so it will have 1 output. And here we have previously 0, so it will have 0. Okay, so 0 and 0. So here we will have 0. Now after this second clock pulse, what will happen? This will be output will be 0 0 1 0 0 0. So after this third clock pulse, similarly we'll have 0 0 0 1 0 0. After this fourth negative edge of the clock, we'll have 0 0 0 0 1 0. After this fifth negative edge, we will have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So after this sixth negative edge, and if we have suppose here 1 override input, after this negative edge of the clock, what will happen? This Q5 output is connected to Q0 input. So previously it was 1, so it will now become 1. And all the remaining will be 0. After 6th clock pulse, this same sequence is repeating now. So we can say that this circuit will give or generate 6 repeated timing signals. This is the solution of the first part of the problem. So in the second part of the problem, what we have to do, we can use a counter and a decoder. So here we can see that in the circuit also we have used here a counter and decoder, but here we can see that we have only 4 outputs. This is 2 into 4 decoder, we will have only 4 outputs. Okay, so what will happen if we use 2 into 4 decoder? We can have only 4 outputs. So for this design, we will have 6 timing signals. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to use here a 3-bit counter. So here we have a 3-bit counter. Suppose here we have this count enable. Okay, so here we'll have 3 outputs because it's a 3-bit counter. So this 3-bit counter can go from 000 up to a maximum of 111. So here we'll have suppose C, B, A. This is A is the suppose most significant bit, and we have to use 1 decoder. So in this case, here we have to use a 3 into 8 decoder because we need 6 output timing sequence. Okay, so this 3 into 8 decoder will have 3 inputs. Okay, 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 square. So that means this is the most significant bit. So it will connect it to this A input. This B will be connected to this 2 to the power 1, and this C is the least significant bit. So it will be connected to 2 to the power 0. We have to go from 000 up to 101. That is 5. From 0 to 5, there will be 6 sequence. Okay. Suppose here we need to get T0, T1, then T2, T3, T4, T5. Up to T5 we want. These 2 outputs we need not to use. So what we have to do, we can give up to 5, that is 101. Okay, up to 101 we can give at this input so that it goes up to T5 only. When ABC is equal to 101 at the counter output, this will make the NAND output is equal to 0. That means we will have an active low signal here. Okay, so this counter will be reset to 000 again. So here we can see that when we have this 101 at this output, okay, this is connected from here, this line, okay, and we have a connection from here. That means we have the most significant bit connected and the least significant bit connected. Whenever we have ABC is equal to 101, that is 1, this is 0, it is not connected, okay, 101 first, okay, at the counter output, this will make the NAND output is equal to 0. That means this NAND gate output will be 0 because we have both the input is equal to 1, 1. So whenever we have 0 at this input, this is the active low signal. This will clear this counter. That means after 101, it will go to 000. So when we get 101 at this output, so at this input of this decoder also will have 101. So this T5 output will be selected. So whenever we have 000, this T0 will be selected. We'll have high signal. And whenever we have 001, this T1 will have high signal. And when we have 010, this T2 will have high signal. When we have 011, okay, at this output, this T3 will be connected. And when we have 100, this T4 will be connected, or T4 will have the high signal or high output, okay, for 1 clock cycle. And with the next clock cycle, we'll have this 101, so this T5 will have a high signal. And after that, this counter is reset, so it will again go to 000. That means this again T0 will be selected. So this is the circuit design for 6 repeated timing signals, okay, as per the conditions given in the question. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, please put it in the comment section below. Also like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.